TPO seaming. TPO is a thermoplastic membrane and performs best when hot air welded together at the seams. Mule-Hide does not approve the use of adhesives or tapes in any TPO to TPO seam. A proper weld, when pulled apart, will separate at the scrim, demonstrating that the weld is stronger than the membrane itself. There are two basic methods to hot air weld: automatic welder or robot, and hand welding with an electric heat gun. TPO is not welded with open flame torches. Mule-Hide requires the use of an automatic welder on all projects requiring a system warranty. There are many different manufacturers of automatic welders. Mule-Hide does not promote one brand over the other, but we do have basic performance requirements. A minimum 1.5-inch weld, minimum 220 volts, and no more than 100 linear feet of cord. Atmospheric conditions will affect how a TPO membrane welds. Always run test welds at the start of each day and any time afterwards following a significant change in temperature. As a starting point, set the automatic welder to 1,000 degrees Fahrenheit and 12.5 feet per minute. Adjust the settings as necessary to maximize productivity while maintaining a proper weld. Use the automatic welder whenever possible. Leaving a minimum 6-inch flange on the deck at all flashings will provide enough clearance to allow the use of most automatic welders. When an automatic welder cannot be used, seaming must be done by hand with a hot air gun. Open flame torches are not used to weld TPO membranes. Most heat guns are 110 volts and are provided with removable tips. Mule-Hide recommends either a 20mm or 40mm tip when welding TPO membranes. Generally, heat guns have two switches, a fan switch and an element, or heat switch. Always turn on the fan first, then the heat. When shutting down, first turn off the heat until the element cools. Then turn off the fan. Failure to shut down in this sequence could cause premature element failure. Mule-Hide requires a minimum 1.5-inch wide well on all hand-welded seams. Regardless of the tip size used, all hand welds require two passes down a seam. The first pass down the seam is to create an air dam. An air dam is required to seal the back of the seam to trap the hot air needed for a proper weld. Insert the tip approximately 2 inches into the seam. On the top sheet, hold the silicone roller roughly 1 inch away and parallel to the end of the heat gun within the seam. In a continual motion, begin rolling across the end of the heat gun while moving it down the seam. Be sure to always keep the roller parallel to the end of the heat. If you have to stop to reposition, always remove the heat gun from the seam. Before completing the second and final pass, gently pull open the seam. Insert the tip of the heat gun into the seam, but leave a small portion of the tip exposed outside the edge of the seam. This will ensure even heat distribution all the way to the outside edge. With continual motion, repeat the rolling process done in the first pass. Be sure to roll out past the outside edge of the seam. Excessive pressure is not required. Always remove the tip from the seam if you need to reposition. Be aware that you may have to go faster than the first pass because you've already preheated the seam. All seams must be probed and repaired as necessary. Allow the membrane to cool. Probing seams that have not thoroughly cooled will create damage. Using pressure, run the seam probe along the edge of the seam looking for voids. Mark the beginning and end of each void so it can be found easily for repair. To repair, simply reheat with a heat gun and roll to weld the void. Things to remember: temperatures will affect how TPO membranes weld. Always run test welds. All welds must be a minimum of 1.5 inches wide. An automatic welder must be used on all projects requiring a system warranty. All hand-welded seams require two passes down the seam. All seams must be probed, even those completed with an automatic welder.